is the lifting system, the main lifting system, together with the 1,300-ton crane, which was used both for assembling the ancillaries and to assemble the lifting system at site. Because of the radius we had to keep, because of the low capacity of the pier, we had to keep a very long radius for installation. So this is rolled out in Korea, the 44,000-ton modules. Very important gorilla, as you can see on the ship. It doesn't actually give the idea of the dimension of this thing, but this is gigantic. It's more than a building. This skidding operation actually took, say, from the initial position to the ship final position, took a little more than a couple of days. So we did the first move up to the edge of the pier, and then the final loadout operation with the installation of the link bridge it has required. This is the sailing way, about 60 days to get from South Korea to Canada, going through Cape Horn. And that's the arrival of the ship in Canada in the fjord, so very calm waters and no major issues with tides there. Very straightforward there, and you have it moored alongside. So when we were talking before about the requirements of having a push and pull system, it's because skidding the modules towards the land by a pulling system would have compressed the ship against the finger pier, and this was just not acceptable. As you see, the lifting system as well as the module that we were seeing before were all pre-staged, so the lifting system was already pre-assembled before the module actually arrived at site. So everything was ready, just waiting for the modules to arrive at site in order to speed up all the integration. You see the module already in front of the lifting system while the ship actually has not yet arrived. So the sequence of operation was very fast, and the schedule was able, we were able to keep the schedule within the 42 days total. This is the animation of the actual loading operation. So a link bridge is positioned onto between the finger pier and the heavy lift ship, and some walk-in area for safety reasons in order to avoid any going into this cold waters in Canada. We don't want to do that. Very narrow area between the load spreaders underneath the UPM modules for access of the skidding system. There was a four-point actually loading system, and the beams you see there are the load spreading onto the four points of the UPM modules. Skidded onto the pier, as I said before, and the module already waiting there to be lifted and skidded onto to the UPM. So there we go, the actual thing. You see the module already on the elevator system, the skidding operation being performed. Again, a couple of days from initial position on the ship onto a little less than a couple of days actually, in the loading operation. And then we start with the actual integration phase. So lifting, skidding, and transversally then skidding the modules to their final position. And there it goes. Try to shift in between the animations and the actual thing, just to show how it was planned, how it was engineered, and how on the other side it was actually performed. So very well planned sequence of operations in order to shift the direction skid system into the transversal skid system. So we had two separate sets of skid systems, one for the longitudinal, one for the transversal. See how the model is moving on your left side into final position, and then in the same position which this module was skidded, the actual drilling tower, so the DES drilling equipment set, was also lifted and skidded into the final position, which is exactly what we're seeing right now. Similar transport configuration in of the two modules, different sets of skidding equipment in order to accelerate the process between the first and the second module in sequence. And speed it up. So there's going the module, lifted and skidded longitudinally. And then from then, there was a jacking down operation to get the module to its final position onto the top side. So we're seeing exactly that, how the module load was shifted from the skidding onto the jacking down system in order to be able to put it at the right correct final elevation on top of the UPM. So this is obviously the longer required time for planning, engineering, in order to be sure that what will has been planned is exactly how it will be performed on site. This is the same thing from another point of view. It's not taking 42 days, but a little bit less. So this is the installation of the flare boom was actually performed just before the living quarter installation. So it's not in the right chronological sequence. Has been performed by Schürrleiter. The original plan actually was to install it by crawler cranes. Our LR 11,250, but it happened to be that the Schürrleiter was at site at the time of the project execution, which was not planned originally. So we changed our plan to a more easy and safer way instead of doing it from land, doing it with the Schürrleiter, which was available there at the time. Okay, this is it.
As a contract